Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode of Career Mode of the Bradford City Variety. And yeah, I hope you guys are enjoying the uploads and the series so far. I just want to say before we start, big thank you once again for 200 subscribers. I said I'm going to be thanking you guys for all the double uploads this weekend, so you'll hear this again tomorrow. But thank you once again for 200 subscribers. It means a lot to me to obviously still have this channel growing, even though it's kind of not growing fast, but I don't really mind about that as long as it's growing at all. So once again, thank you guys for 200 subscribers. But yeah, if you didn't see the last episode, we took on Blackpool, I believe we did. Yep, and we got the victory once again, 2-1 winners in that game. Could have been a bit more either way, to be honest. Both teams could have more goals, but in the end, 2-1 was the final result. And yeah, I don't know really what else to say. I'll show you guys our youth academy quickly. I want to try and check this myself a little bit, actually. We've got Conti, who is the main man. Still not 16 yet. Come on, just age so I can use you. 64 rated, only 15 years of age. Potential of 82 to 88. Looks like a weapon. We've got Govorov, who I'm starting to like a little bit more. He's growing quite well. His potential is 75 to 94, which is why we're keeping him in. Well, he's not. What I'm trying to say, his potential is 75 to 94, but his overall is only 54, which is why we're keeping him in the youth academy for a little while longer. Sokolov, I think I'm going off him, to be honest. Especially when we've got Govorov, who will be better. I'm going to keep Sokolov for now, but I don't know. We've got Donald O'Leary, who he only has shit overall currently. His potential actually doesn't look too bad, so maybe I should be trying to train him a little bit as well. But yeah, those are youth academy for now. Got an update on the league table just quickly before we go into our match against Rochdale. We're in 7th place. Rochdale are 4 points behind us in 9th. And we're 7 points off top spot still with Peterborough continuously winning. We're trying to catch up now. We're trying to play a bit of catch up here. The goal difference for us is not the greatest, but we don't need to talk about that. What we do need to talk about, though, is how we are going to beat Rochdale. And I think I'm just going to go with this team again, despite most of them being tired. Maybe I swap a few out. In fact, I'm going to swap out McCartan. I'll bring in McCartan for Beaton, sorry, because Akpan seems to be doing better than Beaton is. So give Beaton a bit of time on the bench. We've got a couple of reserve players here. I'm going to sort our bench out once and for all, to be honest, because I don't need French there. We'll put Wood there in case we need a left back, or a full back, I should say. Who else? Grinkov. Probably only use him for cup games, to be honest. See if we've got any cup games. I can't remember if we have any cup games. So we got knocked out of the Leeson.com one, and I can't remember what happened to the Carabao Cup one. Oh, we lost to Sheffield, so we've literally only got the FA Cup left. But anyway, I'm going to be using this squadron for this game. Only one change with McCartan coming in ahead of Beaton, so without further ado, we'll just go into it. Don't want to waste too much time rambling. It's kind of a local derby. Did I actually save the career mode over there? I forget again. Hold on. I don't want to lose progress if the game crashes. I need to try and remember to save the career mode between episodes because I seem to forget to do that. Absent-minded. Anyway, yep, we'll go into the Rochdale game now that I've saved it over. And we're going to be the away team, but we're going to wear our home kit. They're also going to wear their home kit. So this is kind of, I wouldn't say it's the local derby, but they're not exactly like opposite ends of the world from each other. They are somewhat close. So we've got Grill in goal, because he's been doing quite well. Kakachi and Henley as the fullbacks. Worrell and Hennessy as the centre-backs. McCartan and Akpan as the centre midfielders. Carbonero and Holoshek as the centre attacking midfielders. And up front, we've got Greenwood and Roberts, who seem to actually be doing okay up front together. So we're going to keep going with this, and hopefully it'll lead us on to glory. This is the third episode I've got to record today out of the four. Obviously, this is double uploads for the weekend, but you guys won't know the difference because most will be going up on Sunday, but I'm recording on the Friday. Let's go into it anyway.
Welcome everyone.
Taking on Rochdale. I'm not sure what their stadium name is, but the Rochdale Arena. What's going to be weird is when or if, I guess, we get to the Premier League and everyone's going to have big stadiums and we'll just still have our little fucking stadium.
Yeah, thank you, Derek. I'm really looking forward to this. Both teams certainly capable of producing some entertaining football. Hopefully,
we've got a strong squad. I'm not sure about their squad. Henderson is the first guy we see on their team. Followed by Lillis. Let's take a look at their lineup, see if I recognise anyone. No one that meets the eye immediately, to be honest. Oh, Wilbraham, he's on the bench. Wilbraham's actually a decent striker. Henderson is the captain and the lone striker. They've all got four at the back, so hopefully we can break through a bit easier than the five at the back, which Blackpool, I believe, had. They're kind of going with our form. Rochdale kind of going with the formation we used to have. Obviously, we've changed our formation now.
It looks pretty orthodox, Lee.
Yeah, I love this formation, 4-4-2. The two main strikers will stay close together. The fullbacks will link up with the wide players. The two holding midfields will sit in front of the centre-backs. Very solid look about this team.
God, Lee Dixon loves this formation. Sure, Jesus Christ. He's really had wet dreams about the 4-4-2. Anyway, we'll get into the game. Rochdale going to be kicking off this match. Henderson, the captain, going to get the ball rolling. And here we go. Can we? I don't want to call it a win streak because I've only won two in a row. But can we continue our winning run? Dooley, tackled by Carbonero, but keeps possession. Carbonero just watching right now. Akpan. Right, come in. Oh, Rochdale building quite well. I don't know how it's not been tackled off him, but Grill, comfortable. Worrell to Kikachi. I'm pretty sure I got tackling with Hennessy there on that guy, but we'll not dwell on it. McCartan, Akpan, Henley. I really want to see Hlushik run through there, but he's not doing so. Pass off to Henley. Roberts to target, it's headed away. Akpan, can he win the header? Nope. McCartan can. No, it's come to Carbonero. Kikachi. Greenwood calling for it through. I was checking out one little pass through to Carbonero and it might have been 1-0 early on. Akpan closed it down, but Akpan's pass is closed down as well. Bit of a stalemate to start off the game.
Well, he's been forced out of play this time.
Rochdale man has run it out of play. I didn't see who it was, but Akpan going to throw it back to Henley. No real speed about any of the Bradford players right now. McCartan. Back to Kikachi. Back into McCartan.
Roberts.
Greenwood. He's going to have to... Excellent. Oh, he's going to have to go so far out here. Greenwood tried to get it back in. That was... Oh, fucking Christ. I shouldn't have taken off balance either. God damn it. Worrell comes for the header. McCartan keeps possession under pressure. Akpan. Roberts.
What can we do from here?
He could take a shot on. It's going to bounce to Greenwood, who just doesn't want to shoot, but he's offside anyway, so it doesn't matter. Unfortunate there. Bounces off the Rochdale man straight to Greenwood, who was offside. Bradford with some attacking pressure there. Nobody marking in the middle. That's interesting. Catchy trying to get the ball. Doesn't succeed.
Others to play it to. Into the advanced position.
Camps now takes it down the wing.
Fruitful looking attack. He's got to stop.
It could work, but
really the
stop. Defense kind of closed down a little bit there, but it worked out in the end. Greenwood.
Might be a chance.
That's
here.
A hell of a foul.
And it's a really poor challenge.
Possibly yellow here. Greenwood's going through the player. Number five, Ryan Delaney. Gonna get yellow card.
Absolutely agree with that one.
Definitely a booking. I thought I could maybe get a heavy touch there, run through and score, but Ryan Delaney chopped me down. Now Greenwood. We're doing all this setting up. I'm just going to pass it off or cross it anyway. I can't shoot free kicks. Suppose I can give it a go, but I know I'm going to miss. Greenwood lining up anyway. We'll just pass it off. Carbonero try to turn. He's been dispossessed. Fuck's sake, man. He just knows I'm going to turn each time. That wasn't the free kick I wanted anyway. I was trying to lay off to Hennessy, who was right next to me, but I guess he didn't want that. Catch him, just the pressure. Kahane, whatever his name is, into making a bad pass. Akpan also made a bad pass. We didn't need pressure for that. He just can't do it anyway. Worrell with a block. The rebound comes straight back though, because of course it does. Why wouldn't it? I mean, realistically, why wouldn't it? And who else is closing down the striker there? Worrell does the initial closing down, but then it just bounces straight back to him and nobody's there on him. Brill's left to do the work and couldn't. And now they've scored.
Well, here is the replay, and to be fair, the keeper from that distance hasn't got much chance of keeping it out. Lovely goal.
Well, let's take another look at that goal, shall we?
1-0, once again, deflection. Wish if, like, sometimes my shots get deflected. I wish it just went straight back to my player instead of just going straight to theirs. They get them all the time, and I had a deflection goal in ages. Henderson and Kiohane in sync there. 1-0 to Rochdale. McCartan. Catch here. He's going to yeet it across pitch, I think. Switch the player. Oh, you've got to be fucking joking me, Henley.
It's opening up for them. Now he must favour the cross. He's got to clatter it away.
Clatter it away, yeah, just pass it along the ground. I'm passing X.
On the break?
Or I'll be in X. McCartan. Greenwood.
Roberts.
Roberts back through to McCartan. Roberts is offside. You can't fuck off, cunt. I hate this game. Oh, built a good chance as well. I knew I was offside. You don't need to show me. Still after the offside. Come to Worrell.
And that's an important
I don't believe that he's passed it like that.
The hosts are struggling in terms of possession, but they won't mind with that. They're winning.
Oh, a perfectly timed pass. And caught with ease. No real threat.
Easy catch for Grill. Worrell's not where I wanted to throw it to, but it works. Karen, Akpan now. Carbonero's screaming for it practically, but now the ball's too heavy. Oh, this team sometimes is so good, sometimes it's just so fucking ass, man. There's literally no in between. They're either really good or really bad.
Delaney. McLaughlin. Henderson.
I pan tried a little lunge in there, didn't work. McLaughlin now for Rochdale.
He continues to make hay. Not getting anxious when they have the ball.
Whenever I lunge, it just slows down my players because I can't unlunge, I guess.
Foul, but advantage played.
Advantage played to Bradford here. I'm not sure what the foul was for, but I'm not going to complain either.
And a chance for him on the
Kloszek.
Space and time for the
cross. Back post to Greenwood, who's put it fucking wide. Fuck off.
Just a little bit off target.
Oh, we're making chances. We just can't put them away.
Well, Derek, there's the life of a manager right there.
Frustration's going to come in at this point.
It's such a thankless job at times.
All right, it's going to come in soon in this game. I'm going to get frustrated with this game at some point. I said earlier I would, and I think it might happen. Worrell should beat Henderson to the header, or not. I guess he didn't have a chance for it. Akpan loses possession way too easily.
McLaughlin.
Delaney. That's McLaughlin.
Henderson.
No. Oh, good job, Worrell. I don't know why the Rochdale player would pass off again, but it was a good defensive job. Greenwood. Carbonero. Back in the middle to Hloszek. Oh, one more onto McCartan. Oh, it's such a good passing move and a good save from Rochdale's goalkeeper.
In
God damn it. Unfortunate there to not get the equaliser, but it wasn't the best of shots realistically.
How many more chances there'll be to get back into this game?
Still got a whole second half yet. A lot of chances. I hope, anyway. Carbonero.
He's driven in the
aiming
corner.
For Hennessy. Okay, interesting play there. I was pointing it to go to Worrell, but he moved. So, Hennessy, I guess, was a target set. Goalkeeper taking his time here. Being a wanker, so we can't equalise half time. McCartan doesn't win the header. Does win possession. Akpan. Greenwood. Can't do anything. There's so many defenders.
He did what he had to do defensively.
So many defenders. Do you want all, put all your entire team on the line, Rochdale, just to defend the entire goal, please? That'd be great. 1-0 to Rochdale at half-time, anyway. Carbonero. Need to do something.
His endeavour, his creativity, his shots at goal, the full works.
Second half, we can bring us back. Kiohane gives Rochdale a lucky lead heading to half-time. Around the grounds, there we go. Some games haven't kicked off yet. Burton Albion once again losing. Match facts. It's a close game, to be honest. But Rochdale just have a slender lead.
The two teams have switched around and are ready now for the second half.
McCartan. Carbonero. Back to McCartan. I just want to get to catch again, please. Thanks. Carbonero. I pressed the A button. Alright, Akpan now. Fucking pissed,
poor
okay.
Attempt at a pass, really. This could be an interesting avenue.
Carbonero, Kakachi.
Space for the cross.
Back post. Oh, it's not going to get to Roberts. And Holoshek can't follow up. It's going to be a throw, though.
It is to be a throw.
To Rochdale, okay. Not what I expected, but sure. Okay, they just kicked off the pitch for no reason. That's fine. We'll get an easy throw in after that. Roberts. Just an easy throw back to Henley. Doesn't attack Pan, who's going to get fouled. Kiohane. Could be a yellow for him, and it will be. I think that's fair. Rochdale complaining about it, but there's no complaints to be had. He didn't even get any of the ball whatsoever. Just all of that pan. Greenwood has got a chance here. I think it's going to be just a ball in, to be honest, rather than an actual shot. But we can do all the stuff if you want to lead up to it. There's no way I'm shooting this. Let's just change the camera angle. Headed away, only as far as Hennessy.
Roberts.
Carbonero. Into Roberts. Don't know if you don't try. It's an easy save for Lillis. Henderson the target. Akpan the interceptor. Watch the guy just falling on his ass there.
Henderson. Giving the ball to the
Henley, Akpan,
time.
Carbonero, Roberts, Greenwood.
Pass. Can he get
back to Roberts. And it's one all. Beautifully made move. The Rochdale defence. I'm not sure what they were doing. Greenwood turns providers. Jordan Roberts seems to find his feet now in Bradford City's football team.
Well, it's a beautifully
take a 2-1
goal.
Lead.
The supply line worked perfectly there, and he finishes it off with ease. Lovely goal. Well, let's go back.
Nice.
To the goal.
Oh, sorry, 2-1 lead. It's 1-1. Am I an idiot? We were losing. I wish we were taking a 2-1 lead, and we might still, but
yes,
my brain.
A show of emotion, and why
come
not?
On. I need my brain cells to just work. Jordan Roberts now. Finding his feet as a striker rather than as a attacking midfielder.
Well, the earlier goal
1-1 now.
One apiece.
Kiahani's goal cancelled out as Roberts equalises. Done now. Done, I don't know. I guess it's done.
Henderson.
You need to not let them get second now, which is easier said than done. That wasn't the pun on the guy's name, by the way. Henderson. It's blocked by Hennessy. The pass. Akpan to Olosek. Not where I don't know why the Albion Y's gone not anywhere there, to be honest. I was aiming for Carbonero, who was making a very good run on the left, and it just didn't go there. Easy for Grill. And now Carbonero will get the ball here. Akpan. Fucking fuck off with these dumb passes.
Moving the ball forward with purpose.
Good save by Grill. Worrell doesn't get it clear fully. Rochdale still very much on with the attack here. Kakache blocks.
And the concession of a corner here.
I should make some substitutions, but I'm not going to. Done with the corner. Or done, actually. I don't. Fuck it, whatever. I'll call him whatever I call him at a particular moment. Grill should catch, and he does. We're going to give it a bit of time to clear out the box there. Oh, Hennessy. Holoshek.
Well, possession tells into Akpan. Nothing really to split the two teams up. You have to say
I passed that off way before he tackled me. Fuck right off, you shit game.
Some really expansive football. You just wonder what the coaches will be saying after this game. Who's going to win it?
Akpan wins the possession back that he should never have lost in the first place. Holoshek, Roberts, Greenwood. Heavy touch. Back through to Roberts. Is he on? No, he's not. Unfortunately. Bring on Mellor, to be honest. We'll never see the offside because I don't care enough. Okay, so we've got 20 minutes to try and take the 3 points here. As the Rochdale, to be honest. I mean, it could go either way. Well, Mellor's going to complain if he doesn't get game time, so it's a win-win. Henley's tired. Carbonero, Greenwood. Try 1-2 Carbonero immediately, but apparently that's not to be because I guess the game didn't want to. Loshek, Roberts. It's come to Greenwood here.
Well, let's get more
just find Roberts, and that's a horrible tackle.
Well, it's a really poor challenge. Now, what's the referee going to do?
What's
going to
happen here now for MJ Williams? Yellow card.
A caution. Well, definitely a yellow card, Derek.
And this might be scorable. Clumsy. Really clumsy. He wasn't even needed. He probably would have got the ball before Roberts did. But regardless, it's now a free kick on the edge of the area for Mason Greenwood. I'd be a fool not to shoot this, but I know I'm not going to score, so. I guess we'll just give it the old college try.
And disappointingly, straight into the wall.
Free kicks on this game are so annoying. The little cursor thing is so bloody sensitive. You move it the tiniest bit, it's like, woo, off the screen. Lilith just takes ages to do anything with the ball and goal. So it's fun. I have to wait 3 days for him. Williams. I better get injury time for him taking forever to fucking do anything with, like a throw or anything. Just anything in goal.
And fuck off.
Akpan's starting to get my nerves. He's good interception wise and he's good defending wise, but his passes are not good.
Morley.
To put it nicely, I guess.
And threading it forward. Surely.
Yep.
Why we adore
of course, my defence will stay in position. Worrell's 9 miles up the pitch, like the and over, Rochdale no, are going to take it, chance, you know.
And there it is, back of the net. It looks like the winner. Well, the
this game is so
goal, Derek, good
fucking
yet,
stupid sometimes.
Slide rule pass.
I don't even know what I'm complaining about. This guy's injured, but he can run through and just score. Yep. Grill can't get a hand to that. Right, it was a good shot,
well,
but come on. I don't know what I'm complaining
away,
about.
Sure.
I'm just complaining
might
that they scored. Ian Henderson, 10 minutes from time. Of course, Rochdale take the lead. Now we need to do something to somehow change anything. The planet, I don't know. I'm going to bring on two strikers. I hope. Bring on two strikers and hope for the best.
So two substitutes to come on in one go.
Fuck it, we need all we can now.
Well, as they kick off again, 2-1 the current state of affairs. Only 10 minutes remaining here.
Mello, do you want to make a run? You're literally one of the most freshest men on the pitch. You can stand there. Everyone else is busting the gut to try and get an equaliser here. Can't do anything because there's nobody moving. No movement at all.
Just
that's
listen
fine.
To the fans here, Derek. They've just kept their noses in front, and these fans are doing their best to push them to the
Hennessy
final.
Hennessy heads
whistle.
It away to Meller. Akpan doesn't get the ball. Somehow doesn't get the ball. I'm not sure exactly. Carbonero is the target for the throw here. Nice. Carton. Patrick's
he's
fucking offside, isn't he? Fuck off, man.
Well, he saw the whites of the keeper's eyes.
Oh, he wasn't even offside. I'm going to lose my mind.
Well, he's denied a certain goal.
I thought he was offside, so I didn't fucking try. Oh, my God. I'm going to crucify myself. Oh.
So the corner played into the box.
Worrell. And the doesn't header it. Hennessy. Fuck it. Jesus Christ. I've never seen a shot with less power on it in my life. You better not waste your ass. Fucking ass time just deciding what to do with that. Yep, okay, good. I was trying to complain, they'd already thrown it, so.
Henderson. Unable to keep the ball that time.
Please, guys, please.
And slipped through beautifully.
I don't know what to do. Their keeper saves everything, the bykeeper doesn't. Patrick's had two really good chances here now. To equalise it for us, and you just can't. I don't think we're going to get a point here. I mean, we're still going to try, obviously, but I don't see it happening. Hennessy, for some reason, the target. Akpan. Akpan can't pass. Why am I trying to pass him? I should have just gone for a shot. Fuck off, you cunt.
Andrew.
Morley. Oh, yo-yo form.
Well, he's got plenty of space on the flank here.
Might not be over yet.
The delivery. Well, he knew he had to get to the ball, and he
just
did.
Just one score another.
And there goes the
Rochdale win. Pretty undeservedly, in my opinion, but that's just me being biased as a Bradford City manager, so do as you will. I hate how my defence can be so good sometimes and then just shit the other times. And what pisses me off the most, I know it's a stupid thing, but what pisses me off the most is whenever my players do good and we get a big win, nobody gets a feature on my team unless they've done extremely well. These guys do shit and one of them gets a feature anyway. I mean, they did well because they won, obviously, but they just, I don't know, I'm mad. Ignore me, I'm not making any sense. Fuck right off. I'm blaming that on fatigue and tiredness, to be honest. Not full fitness, that's what it was. Wasn't much to talk about in that game besides the shots. It was a very even game, to be honest. They're just lucky to get the fucking winning goal, the twat. Man of the match doesn't go to any of our guys, but player of the... Well, 8.1s for Greenwood and Roberts, best players on our team, as always. Everyone else putting in an okay effort. Their best player and man of the match was Kiohane, 8.3. Henderson, the other goalkeeper, other goal scorer, of course, an 8.1, so... Was a very close match. It's got a lucky goal. And I'm going to get asked about it in this interview. Oh, they scored in the last minute to win the match. Yep, they did. Here we
can
go.
Can I ask you a couple of questions?
Unfortunately for your team, Rochdale managed to score the winner during the last minutes. Haha, who would have guessed? It's a very tight game. What do you make of it? Bullshit! Just unlucky. We were just unlucky today. Boys played well. Any other day we would have won it. It's just seems to lose like this, but we'll keep our chin up and focus on the next games. Well, disappointing result today. What were we wrong in your opinion? Nothing per se, to be honest. He just got lucky. We were just unlucky. I already told you. Well, I thought we played well the other day. We could easily have won. Unfortunately, that's football. You, it wasn't meant to. It's football for you, and it wasn't meant to be. I've given the same answer twice now. Kieran was one of the best players in the opposition today. Is his confident display in defence the reason behind your failure to gain a positive result against Rochdale? We need to concentrate on what we could do better. I prefer to concentrate on what we could do better. There are areas of our game that you weren't questioned about it. I always say this, and I always try and fix it, and it always just ends up the same result.
That'll be all, thank you.
No problem. Yo-yo form. If anyone doesn't get what I'm meaning by yo-yo form, I win some and I lose some. It's just, there's no rhythm to it, really. Rossi wants something. Boss, I may not be the first name on the team sheet, but I feel like I should begin some more playtime. Your rotation. I'll consider your request. I'm probably going to say no, because I'm still pissed at you for conceding three against a League 2 team, but... maybe I will play him, actually, just because Grill might be tired. Still in 7th. Charlton are falling down, anyway. Woods wanting the match. I've been in pretty good form. And I'm feeling good, so we're not going to bench me for the game against Oxford United. There's bigger games ahead. There's bigger games ahead, and I'll need you focusing on fitness until then. We'll just do that, because that means if I tell him that, he knows he's not going to play. And I know he's not going to play. Everyone knows he's not going to play, and we're all good. I'm going to give Rossi the start. Something I may later regret. I'm going to bring on Beaton for Akpan. Try to see what Beaton and McCartan midfield can do. Obviously, the youth players will try and switch in at points, but I don't know when those points will be. Especially with more cup games. Alright, so next time we're going to be facing Oxford United. Unfortunately, we couldn't get the win today, which means we're going back into yo-yo form. Yay, I love to see it. Which means we probably will lose next time to Oxford, but anything's possible. I just hope we can get the win against them. But like I said, yo-yo form is taking over again. I hope you guys have enjoyed another episode of the Bradford City Career Mode. I'll see you very, very soon when we take on Oxford United. Goodbye for now.